Hello, mathematics students. In this tutorial, we are going to look at the problems which are related to contents of week 2, that is to do with straight lines and all these topics here. So, we'll start with our first question. The data provided here is there is a company which is selling mobile phones, and it all begins in March 2019. In March 2019, the selling price was 8000 and it was sold at 8000 rupees. Mobile A was sold at 8000 rupees from March until June, and after that, due to increasing demand, the company decided to increase the price by 250 each month. So they're selling better. So they have decided to increase their price by 250 rupees every month. This went on until a new mobile B was launched at a lesser price. Competition at a lesser price was launched in January. So because of this, the selling price of A dropped at a rate of 500 per month. From January till March 2020. So, 2 months it had decreased. We are expected to demonstrate a clear graph of this. For that, let's look at this graph. What we need to realize about situations like this is the x and y axis do not necessarily represent the same units, right? So, we have along the x axis one unit is 1 month. However, along the y-axis, one unit is, let's take about 250 rupees. So, 1 month and 250 rupees are not the same thing. So, please remember this in situations like this. Now, because we are beginning from March, let's take the starting month to be March, and then this is April, May, and so on. So, our entire problem deals with this 1 year span from March 2019 to March 2020. So, this will be along our x-axis. And now, along the y-axis, if we took each unit to be 250, then this is 250 and this is 500 and so on. The 8000 will be beyond our screen. So, to better represent our situation, we are going to introduce a zigzag here to indicate that a lot of values have been compressed into this little space. So, we are going to start from 8000 and this is going to be 8250, 8500, so on. And now we begin to mark out the points that we have. We know that in month of March, the price was 8000. So, this is the point for the month of March. And then in April, May, and June, the price stayed constant. So, it's been like this. And this portion can be represented using a horizontal line. And this line is y is equal to 8000. Beyond that, the price had been increasing by 250 every month. So, in July, we will be here, August here, September here, oh, this will be October, this will be November, this is December, and this is January. So, this segment can be indicated by this line. In order to find out the equation of this line, we use the two-point form. So, we first identify 2 points on this line segment. We could choose this one, which is August. And for that, let's number our months now. So, March will be 0, April is 1, May is 2. June is 3, this is 4, and this is 5. So, our price point here, it is 5,8,500. And we need to take another month. So let us take October. This is the 7th month from March 2019. So this point becomes 7,9,000. Right, using these two points, we can find the equation of the line by employing the two-point form of the line equation, which is y minus y1 by x minus x1 is equal to y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1, where x1, y1 and x2, y2 are two points on the line segment. So, here we can see it as y minus 8,500 by x minus 5 would give us 9,000 minus 8,500 by 7 minus 5. So, this would be equal to 500 by 2, which is 250. So, that implies y minus 8,500 is then 250 times x minus 5, which finally gives us the line equation to be y is equal to 250x minus 1250 plus 8,500. Thus, this line is y is equal to 250x plus 7,250. Moving on. The next 2 months, the price dropped by 500 each month. So, here we are at 9750. Then for February, we should be at 9250. So, this will be our point for February. And then the next month again, a 500 drop, we will reach here, which is 8750. And this line segment also corresponds to a straight line, which also we can find using the two-point form. So, this point here is, let's number the months completely. This is 8, this is 9, this is 10, this is 11, this is 12. So, this point here, which is January, is the 10th month. And the y-axis gives us 9750. Whereas this point here, this is the 12th month. And it corresponds to 8750. And again, we would like to know the line equation for this, and we use the two-point form again. So, this is y minus 8750 by x minus 12 is equal to 9750 minus 8750 by 10 minus 12. That gives us 1000 by minus 2, which is minus 500. Thus, we have y minus 8750 is equal to minus 500x plus 6000. That gives us y is equal to minus 500x plus 14750. So, this is our new line. And this is a clear graph of the situation in the given question. For the part B of this question, it's asked, what is the price of mobile A in December? So, this is the December month, which would be this point here, which has a price of 9,500. So, this is our answer for B. And then in C, it is asked, calculate the slope of mobile A's price from January to March 2020. So, we want the slope of this segment here. And this slope we had already calculated. It was 9,750 minus 8,750 divided by 10 minus 12. This is our slope M. That gives us 1000 by minus 2, which finally gives us the slope is negative 500, it is minus 500, and because of the negative slope, you can see that it is a decreasing function, which is what is happening. The price had fallen at 500 per month. Lastly, we are being asked, what is the price of mobile A in March 2020? So, this is March 2020. This is our point, and we've already found the price. It is 8750. That is our part.